Well, traffic is flowing again on Interstate 85 in Greenville County after a deadly crash involving a FedEx trailer. The wreck happened just before 3 o'clock this morning in the northbound lanes of I-85 at Malden Road. News 4's Kim Quintero joins us live and local from the Greenville newsroom this morning. Kim, any word on who died in this crash?
Well, just moments ago, the Greenville County coroner identified the driver who died in that crash as 22-year-old Cameron Lee Chapman of Greenville. Troopers say he was not wearing a seatbelt and drove the wrong way down Interstate 85 before colliding with the FedEx trailer.
Take a look at this. Smoke billowing from a FedEx tractor trailer on busy Interstate 85. Sky 4 flew over the scene of the fiery crash that happened during the rainy Monday morning commute in Greenville County. A wrong-way driver in a Toyota Camry was no match for the massive rig and died on impact. As the investigation unfolded, drivers traveled at a snail's pace for about 5 miles south of Malden Road. Mrs. Raja was caught in the snarled traffic on her way into work at this gas station.
All the police car light was flashing and traffic was slow, and you know, I thought I never would get here.
385 was backed up.
Meanwhile, workers at the nearby FedEx ground station filtered calls from concerned family members while managers tried to figure out how to handle all the letters and packages destroyed in the blaze.
And I'm told that none of those packages were going to or coming from any towns in our area. And troopers say the driver of the FedEx trailer was 50-year-old Royce Wade of Taylorsville, North Carolina. He was not injured, but his passenger, 57-year-old Arvelin Taylor from Matthews, North Carolina, was not wearing his seatbelt and taken to Greenville Memorial Hospital for his injuries. The cause of the crash is still under investigation. Kim Quintero, WYFF News 4, live in the Greenville newsroom.